Okay, this video is for Timpanogos Gateway, unit number 307. We're going to be located about 1900 North and North Canyon Road, which you can see the BYU football stadium right there behind it. Very easy access to BYU. In fact, BYU basically owns the property just right kitty corner from here. You can see on this one, this is actually a different building, but they're all done with very low maintenance exteriors. So you can see all the stairwells are covered and stucco, brick on the bottom, very easy to maintain, pitched roofs, that sort of thing. There's gonna be, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 buildings out here. And we'll have a mix of both boys and girls. So it creates a nice mix as far as the social aspect is on here. So right here, you can see the parking. Timpanogos Gateway does not have any issues with parking because every unit's going to have basically 3 stalls for 3 people. So everyone here can have a car and you won't have any problem. Okay, so this one is going to be located on the top floor. So biggest benefit that you're going to get on the upper floor is this vaulted ceiling. It's extremely nice. Now this particular one has had a lot of upgrades done to it. So normally, and Timpanogos Gateways were built very nice in the beginning. So you can see here, you've got the tile floor, and we've got it in the entry, as well in the dining room and kitchen. We're gonna see it also in the bathrooms. So some of the features that were done on this particular one, I'll just try to point them out as we go along, is that it was wired for a security system. They're not using it now, but you can see here, it's gonna be a door sensor right there. We've got the glass breakage sensor right up here. You're on the third floor, so it pretty much almost take, you know, Spider-Man to get up here and get in, but very nice. So right here is gonna be the living room area. And if it wasn't a cloudy day today, you'd actually have a great shot of Mount Timpanogos right from this location. So here's gonna be the dining area. You can see the bar counter. And then I'm gonna kind of move around here where we've got the built-in desk, a little bit of storage above. Going on back into the kitchen. This right here is going to be a nice pantry. So plenty of room for the three boys to have their stuff. Over the range microwave, there's a shot of the range. And then I'll kind of spin around this direction here so you can see the dishwasher. Looking out into the living room. And then right in here, you can see it's upgraded dishwasher. You have stainless steel on the inside. And then even up here on the cabinets, they have the nice crown trim on them as well, which a lot of times you will not see in the student condos. So right here, they've added this door. Originally, this would have been open, but this is gonna make a great privacy door. So that can close off. I'll kind of back up so you can see. That can close off. And you'll see the bedroom and bathroom area, it will give them total privacy if there was a study group going on out here in the living room. These guys can move around back here in the bedroom area without any problem at all. So we'll kind of head down the hall. There's gonna be 3 bedrooms. 2 will be on this side, and then 1 will be on the opposite side. So right here you can see they've got ceiling fans in here, which is nice. Nice big bedrooms. For a private room, this is about as big as you get. So there's a shot of their desk and dresser. We've got the 2-inch blinds. And then I'll try to, oops, wrong side. There we go. I can open it up here. You can have great views that kind of look on out that direction. And then going around this side, a nice big closet, especially for guys. But you can see on how much space is in this closet. Of course, we got the shelf on the top. So really gives them tons of room. And this isn't even the biggest room so far. So right here is going to be a linen closet. So students, that's storage basically for them. And then moving on into this bedroom. This is gonna be our largest room. Also has a ceiling fan. The views can be basically the same. And then kind of looking around here, and I'm gonna go around this direction. You can kind of see back. Bedrooms are always tricky to shoot. And so right here, you've got this big walk-in closet. So these shelves here were added in and to give more storage. But then you got the closet bar going across here, and then you have another one right here going perpendicular to it. So as we go on down the hallway here, this is going to be the first of two baths. So first bath right here is going to have the tile, like I mentioned on it, and you can see the sink area there with the vanity, nice big mirror, is separated from the toilet and the shower area by a door. And so that allows basically two guys to be able to get ready at the same time. Great design for the students. You can see in here also that they've gone with the molded fiberglass surround, so there is no grout issues to deal with that direction. Really a great way to go for students, especially. Even on this, they've got the curved bar for the shower curtain, which you don't normally see on the student properties. Going on down the hallway here, this door is going to have the washer and dryer. So we got side-by-side washer and dryer. Both are Whirlpool, and this light was actually added in on that, and then you can see the shelf right along the top. And then the bifold doors will close and just keep it nice and out of the way, tucked out of the way. So this has also been upgraded from the original furnace and cooling unit here. So you can see right here they put a Bryant system in, but then also this one is going to have a water softener. Almost never see that on student properties, but it's a great way if you've got a kid with eczema, or you know, obviously just take care of your plumbing and your dishwasher, things like that. That goes a long way. Then right back in here, you can see that these use the Maniblock system, which is kind of like a circuit breaker basically for the plumbing. So you can actually control the hot water side of the shower, for example, and turn it off separate from the cold on there, and really have easy access to with the straight line on that. All right, here is you're going to have the thermostat. Obviously, that's been upgraded to a digital thermostat. This is going to be the second bathroom here. Same tile, basically the same setup as what we saw here in the first one. So this door is going to separate off the shower area right there. And then our last bedroom is right here. Still has the 2-inch blinds. Really good size. I mean, bedrooms are always kind of hard to shoot, so I'm trying to shoot this in a couple different angles here. So there's going to be his closet, and then I'll kind of come over here, pan around this way so you can see the dresser and the desk. Now, the other thing that's cool, and we've got actually another breakage alarm right there. The other thing that's really cool on this one, too, is they actually rewired the internet wire in here from the original, which allows you to go with the Cat5e wire, which is going to allow you to take full advantage of Google's 1,000 megabyte speed, which is all pre-wired for this unit as well. So looking on out here, just going right back to where we started in the living room. And so that is Tippinogas Gateway unit number 307.